Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. And guys, in this series, this is my third video, and we are going to understand what are the basics of website and site winding on Server 2019. If we want to wind any website, we have created any website and we wind it to, so what are the options we have available? So I will show you one thing here. I'm using Server 2019 here. Okay, so all configuration will be done on this server. So as of now, there is nothing configured. I just installed IIS, and this is IIS manager here, and you can see this is Server 2019. Okay, and Server 2019 is standard evaluation version I'm using, and I will be talking about like when we create websites, how we can wind it and all, what and all options we have. I hope this video will be informative. So guys, first of all we should understand understanding website. So website, what is website and how it is how it is applicable. So website are top level container. So basically it is a container. Okay, you can consider this is a container, this one is a container, and certain contents are kept on this or inside this or in this, you can say. Okay, and whatever we access, that call content. If I'm accessing Google or Facebook or YouTube, if I click to any image, if I click to any song, that call content. Okay, and it can be like hundreds or thousands of pages inside that website. So website will be inside one container, and what this website will contain, it will contain lots of pages of information, and every website should be mapped to physical path of the server. So the meaning is very simple. In previous video I showed you one thing. If we create any website here, if this default website is created here, so it has created one folder, okay, by default, and it is stored here. This IIS start, if you click this, it will open automatically. It is created by default. So if we create any website, then we need to map that website to this physical folder here. Okay, so how to do it, we will understand in coming up videos. That is the first requirement. We have to be very sure about it, like there should not be any misconfiguration. Website should be working and it should be properly mapped to physical path of server. Next thing, the physical path of the server or root folders should be accessible to for contents. So the meaning is very simple, that physical path, it should be accessible. That hard drive, that drive wherever we are keeping this website, should be accessible. Very simple requirement. Next thing, websites winding. So guys, there are four types we can use, or we can bind a website using four different mechanism here. The very first thing is type, okay, and the second one is IP address, third one is port, and fourth one is host name. So I will show you all these things one by one in my coming up video. So very first thing here, if we talk about type, what is type? So it specifies what type of protocol will be used. Very simple, if you are binding with type, so what kind of protocol you are using, like HTTP or HTTPS. So here by mistake I mentioned HTTPS, both, one is HTTP and HTTPS. So these are also called as a protocol or standards. In my previous video I spoke about couple of things, HTTP, HTTPS and HTTP2. Okay, so either we can use HTTP or HTTPS. If I show you here, by default website, this one, and if you go to property, winding option, so it is mapped to, or it is binded to HTTP. Okay, so this is how we can, you can see here type also, and you can see host name, port, IP address, winding information. So these are the winding options. So we will understand all those things one by one in coming up videos. Next one here, IP address. It specifies what type of IP will be used and on which server will respond. So by default there are two IP address we use generally, IP version 4 and IP version 6 is not in use in India as of now. Might be it is in use. So I have worked on IP version 4 only. So guys, how we can map it? If you want to map it, like one IP to one website, okay, one condition, multiple website to one IP. Second condition, multiple IPs to multiple website can be configured. these are the conditions we can configure. And unassigned means website can take any IP which is available. So if you are using unassigned, then if you have any unused IP address, that can be taken by the website which is available. We do not need to specify any particular IP address in this condition. If any IP address available, the website will take that IP address. So this is the second method, you can say, of binding. Next is port. So again, we can specify on which server will respond to request. If any request, this is my IIS server, okay. For example, if any request is coming from this site client, like I'm giving HTTP facebook.com. So here it specifies on which port server will respond. So it will check which port request is coming like that. So we can bind that website like that only if it is coming HTTP, and if that is bind to HTTPS, so that will not respond to that request. Okay, default port is 80 HTTP and can be changed to HTTPS, which is secure. 443 is port number for that. And for example, HTTPS www.india.com and :5000. So like this is just an example, and like this we can configure very easily. Next one, host name. This setting allows multiple website to share name, okay, IP, protocol, port number. For this we need to configure DNS to respond and resolve website names. So DNS is very common or very important in this kind of configuration if we are mapping any website to host name. So I will show you how to map to a how to map a website to host name and how to do it. Very easy, there is nothing fancy, nothing difficult, very simple configuration. If you subscribe my channel, so you will be getting all the updated videos, coming up videos. In this video guys, this much information only: IP address, how we can wind, and type, IP address, port and host name. So in my next video I'll be talking about the how we can create one website and how we can bind it. So guys, if you want to understand further configuration and all, just subscribe the channel, comment, share and like this video. Till then, bye bye, have a nice time. Thanks for watching for this video, and next video I'll be talking about hosting website.